covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News, first at 4.
A fugitive and a widow. Today, a Wellington woman charged along with her husband with disappearing with $10 million is now facing questions and even federal charges. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Felicia Rodriguez.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. Peggy Gamblin was in federal court in West Palm Beach. Terry Parker has live coverage with the mystery surrounding the charges against her. Terry?
Tiffany, not only do prosecutors want to know what happened to the missing $10 million Peggy Gamblin and her now deceased husband are accused of stealing, they also want to know what happened to the couple's best friend who disappeared at sea 5 years ago.
Fugitive Roger Gamblin died last month, weeks after being captured in Colorado and brought back to face federal fraud charges for looting his title company of $10 million. Wednesday, his wife and co-defendant faced the judge alone.
Peggy is, in my estimation, still somewhat in shock over just a confluence of factors that have happened.
Peggy Gamblin's attorney is waiting to find out how much of a case the government has against her. But one thing he knows, prosecutors also want to know how much Peggy can tell them about the disappearance at sea of family friend Jim Trindade.
If she knows that information, I'm going to use that to the best of my ability to get some concessions from the government.
Peggy Gamblin and Roger were both indicted in 2009 after they disappeared from their Wellington area home, leaving their Flagler title company in tatters. They fled 2 years after Roger Gamblin's best friend, Trindade, disappeared at sea while returning from a Gamblin-Trindade family vacation in the Bahamas. Investigators said Gamblin's son, Chris Gamblin, and his friend, Brian Pratts, were the last ones to see Trindade alive. Homeland Security said at the time that Chris Gamblin and Pratts were considered persons of interest. The elder Gamblins fled during that investigation, but they were arrested in Colorado after Roger checked himself into an emergency room. Prosecutors and a Homeland Security agent met with Gamblin's attorney Wednesday to talk about the missing millions and the missing friend, urging him to let Peggy talk.
Fine, I'll use that if I can use it. She's not charged with that. She's not involved with anything that I know of. So I don't mean to disappoint you, but that's all it is.
A lot to this case now. The prosecutors have 14 days to turn over all of their evidence against Peggy Gamblin to that defense attorney, and then he says he's going to decide whether to try and negotiate a plea deal or battle up for trial. Felicia?
Terry, there seems to be a lot more questions than answers. Do they think Peggy was in on this theft from the title company, and does she know anything about the missing friend?
Well, she was a registered title agent at her husband's company, and she was married to the guy that supposedly, they say, took the money and ran, and she was on the lam with him for 2 years. So prosecutors are saying, if you know something, we are willing to work with you, maybe give you some concessions. But even her attorney tells me he doesn't even know whether she knows what happened to Jim Trindade. All of that's sure to come out sooner or later. Live in the newsroom, Terry Parker, WPBF 25 News.